Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. In today's episode, we're talking about stance length. Should I have a short stance or a long stance? That's what I'm going to explain in today's video. When talking about fighting stance, a lot of times we get the different types, a boxing stance, more of a kickboxing stance, a karate side stance, but we never really talk about stance length. But stance length is very important. It's how long are my feet gonna be? And depending on what you're gonna do, you want a certain type of stance length, and that's what I'm gonna talk about today. So the key thing, which I like to talk about, is understanding that you have to have a defensive stance and an offensive stance. When you're talking about defensive stance, I like to have my stance a little bit shorter. So the weight distribution in this stance is gonna be about 50-50 between my front and back leg, because this way I'm able to block with the lead leg. If I'm too heavy on my front leg, it's very difficult for me to be able to block. So now if I'm in a very long stance now and I'm trying to block a low kick, it's almost impossible. So me being a low kicker, I always check the length of my opponent's stance. If I see them in a nice long stance or the heel turned out, then I know my low kick's gonna be a little bit more effective. So the defensive stance is a little shorter and about 50-50 in weight distribution. So I can lift my legs up with both sides. So if I'm blocking a good powerful left kick, for example, I'm able to lift my rear leg no problem because the weight distribution is 50-50. Okay, and also the benefit of a defensive stance is now when I decide to attack, I step. I always talk about in any strike that I've talked about in the beginning of this channel, you have to make sure you enter and you exit. So entering with a step helps you get momentum, helps you drive that power from the calves into your strikes. So from that defensive stance, I step to lengthen my stance, and now I'm in a longer stance. That longer stance, now the benefit is gonna give me more power. In that longer stance, I have more rotation and be able to turn and get my punches over. Now, the key thing about the long stance is really important when it comes to kickboxing. Boxing, not so much. In boxing, you're gonna notice you like to have a little bit of a smaller stance, shorter, because this way you can generate power, use pivoting and angling, and there's no kicks and knees. But when you wanna kick a knee now, the offensive stance plays in your favor. By stepping, lengthening the stance, now you have that length to get good power in your rear round kick. And that's the key. You need to have that long stance. If I'm gonna throw a round kick with a short stance, I call it more of the bunt swing. It's more of a shorter, more powerful, which is okay if you're looking for a quick counter. But when you're looking for that big power low kick or that knockout shot, you need that lengthened stance to be able to get your hips involved and to be able to get that kick with full length and good power. So it's important to understand, what are you trying to do? Defensive stance blocking, offensive longer stance is better for my combination flow and power, especially when it comes to the rear kick. But it's also important too, you might wanna shorten your stance for different times. Remember, it's kickboxing, right? In MMA, the same thing. You have to be able to box and you have to be able to kick. So being able to adjust the stance late mid-combination or mid-fight is just as important. For example, I can throw the 1-2 and keep it in a nice long stance, which is nice. I can still get good power, good extension, and still kick. But now, if I want to box, say the advantage is in my hands and I want to knock my opponent out with good power, I might want to punch and shorten my stance to get that power in that rear hand. So step, and then I step again. This way, the power in my rear hand is a lot stronger and better chance that I can get the knockout. So understanding that power coming forward in the hands tends to be better in a smaller stance. Kicking, I need the longer stance. So you're gonna notice that as you get more advanced, this just happens naturally in the fight, but you still need to be aware of it. For example, if you're eating too many low kicks and you're having trouble blocking, it's probably because your stance is too long. Or you're having a hard time getting power in your hands, you might wanna shorten your stance. So depending on what you're going for, you need to understand and keep an eye on your stance length. Hey, and it's not a bad idea to check your opponent's stance when they're doing it. You might wanna attack those low kicks when they're in that long stance. Okay, so make sure you keep liking, subscribing to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA, and we'll see you next week.